Seoul, Reuters. Perhaps none of the communist legacies shared by Vietnam and North Korea highlighted during Kim Jong-un's goodwill visit to Hanoi is stranger than the ABAL made leaders on display in their capital cities in the secretive team of Russian technicians that keeps the aging bodies looking ageless. File photo, the body of North Korean leader Kim Jong-il is instead at the Kumsusan Memorial Palace in Pyongyang in this picture released by the North's official KCNA news agency early December 21, 2011. KCNA via Reuters. File photo. Kim laid a wreath outside Ho Chi Minh's mausoleum in the Vietnamese capital on Saturday after the conclusion of his short and summit with U.S. President Donald Trump. Inside the dark interior of the mausoleum, the ABAL made corpse of Vietnam's founding father Lee's displayed in a glass coffin for a steady stream of tourists who silently shuffle by. In Pyongyang, Kim Jong-un's grandfather and father are on similar display in the loftily named Kumsusan Palace of the Sun-A monument to the cult of personality that surrounds North Korea's ruling family. All three leaders were originally preserved by a team of specialists from the so-called Lenin Lab in Moscow, which first ABAL made and displayed Vladimir Lenin's body in 1924. The Soviet Union may have collapsed and socialism in both Vietnam and North Korea has taken on forms barely recognizable to the ideology's first thinkers, but that same lab still performs annual maintenance on Ho Chi Minh, according to at least one researcher, still helps North Korea keep the Kims looking fresh. The original abaming and the regular abamings have always been conducted by the scientists of the Moscow lab, said Alex Ayushak, a professor of anthropology at the University of California, Berkeley, who is writing a book about the ABAL with communist leaders. Over the years they trained local scientists in some techniques but not all, maintaining the core of the know-how secret. Bodywork, unlike earlier preservation, possesses such as mummification. The permanent abalming pioneered by Soviet scientists kept the bodies flexible, with unblemished skin and a lifelike, if rather waxy, pallor. With North Vietnam under regular attack by American war planners at the time of Ho's death in 1969, the Soviet Union airlifted chemicals and equipment to a cave outside Hanoi, which the Soviet experts turned into a sterile lab, Jurschak said. When the Soviet Union collapsed in the 1990s, the government lab faced a funding crisis, leading it to rely more heavily on offering services to foreign clients, Jurschak said. Among those customers was North Korea, where Russian specialists ABAL mit both Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il at a laboratory built into the mausoleum in Pyongyang. The original abaming takes several months, and the bodies need regular upkeep. Everyone and a half to 2 years these bodies are re-abalmed by the Moscow scientists. Jurschak said, citing interviews he conducted with lab scientists in his own field research. The website for the committee that manages Ho's mausoleum says Russia started charging for the chemicals after the Soviet Union collapsed, prompting Hanoi to ask that the supplies be produced in Vietnam. Vietnam has also sent technicians to study in Russia and can now handle the operations of the mausoleum by itself, the website says. A source with committee, however, confirmed the monument is closed every year for 2 months and that Russian technicians help with annual maintenance of the body. When contacted by Reuters, the mausoleum lab in Moscow, which since 1992 has been known as the Center for Scientific Research and Teaching Methods in Biochemical Technologies, declined to comment on any aspect of its work. the North Korean delegation at the United Nations did not respond to a request for comment. Researcher Tom Foddy, who founded a group promoting tourism and cultural engagements in North Korea, said he has seen the Kumsusan Palace closed for unexplained renovations, but maintenance of the bodies is a mystery. While it is obvious the methodology was derived from Russia, it will be a closely kept secret, he said. Some experts say China, which relied on its own scientists to ally with Mao Zedong because of tension between Beijing and Moscow at the time, may have taught or helped North Korea. Changing symbols. Visitors to Pyongyang's Kumsusan Palace pass displays that include Kim Jong-il's personal yacht and an Apple computer the dictator had once owned, before being required to bow three times to the bodies. The personality politics of the Kim succeeds all others. Foddy said, noting that maintaining the memorial will continue to receive overwhelming priority in North Korea's government budgeting. It's not clear how much impoverished North Korea spends on maintaining the Kim's bodies. When Moscow released preservation costs for the first time in 2016, it reported spending nearly $200,000 that year to maintain Lenin. File photo, North Korean leader Kim Jong-un lays wreaths at Ho Chi Minh Mausoleum in Hanoi, Vietnam March 2, 2019. In this photo released by North Korea's Korean Central News Agency, KCNA on March 2, 2019. KCNA via Reuters file photo originally the Abalming was seen as a way of joining the various countries to international communism as embodied in Lenin. But as Vietnam and North Korea developed in their different political ways, so has the meaning attached to preserving the leaders' bodies. Today this original meaning of these bodies has changed. In Vietnam the body of Ho today stands for anti-colonial struggles, for independence and even for new nationalism, much more than for communism, Yushak said. In North Korea the two Kim's bodies stand for a self-sufficient country organized around one leader and existing in the face of the imperialist surroundings. Reporting by Josh Smith. Additional reporting by Tom Balmforth in MOSCOW in Canvu in HANOI, editing by Lincoln Fistur Standards. The Thomson Reuters Trust Principles.